Hi, welcome to the 29th floor. I'm Noah Robichon here with senior writer Austin Carr. Today we want to talk about The Late Show with Stephen Colbert. He's invited a bunch of technology celebrities. The CEO of Apple, the CEO of Uber, and the CEO of Tesla have all appeared in the first 2 weeks. Austin, what is this telling us about the celebrity of Silicon Valley?
He thinks that these people have the same draw, the same star power as some of these A-list celebrities in Hollywood.
So first up was Elon Musk, the fabulous, brainy CEO of Tesla and SpaceX, and truly a genius. I mean, the guy is incredible, although not necessarily known for his skills sitting on the chair across from like a late night TV show.
What Elon has always done well is sort of let his company speak for themselves. So you don't have to be the most hilarious, charismatic anecdote teller when you're going to the moon and saving the world.
That said, he has gotten much better when he's on stage. He's developed a stage presence. But so how do you do on Colbert?
I thought he did as I expected him to do, which is to say he let Colbert be the funny one and sort of, set up a lot of the jokes. You know, overall, he's not, no offense to Elon, but he's not George Clooney telling, anecdotes about, going to the Oscars or whatever, right?
But did he ask, like, hard questions? This may be actually, this is a good question for his second guest, which was Travis Kalanick, the CEO of Uber. How did he do on Colbert, and did Colbert ask him any of the tough questions?
He did ask Travis about sort of the feuds between traditional taxi drivers and Uber and what that's doing to their sort of economy. And I actually think it was a good platform to Travis respond to a very mainstream audience about this issue.
Yeah. How did he seem on TV? What kind of personality came through?
He was a little bit maybe uncomfortable, and we all would be. I mean, this is the first time not only on that type of platform, but also on a completely brand new show. That was the second or third day, so you didn't know what you were going into.
So let's review the third, which was Apple CEO Tim Cook, who seemed pretty comfortable up there, actually.
Yep.
Comparatively, he was very relaxed and seemed very open with Colbert. What did he talk about?
They talked about both the new iPhone, but they also veered into talking about gay rights and how Tim Cook came out recently.
Uh-huh.
Tim Cook had compared that to, he said, a lot of people knew I was gay, but not everyone was truly sure. And that's the same way as, there's been a feature in the iPhone that you always knew was there, but you didn't quite know how to use it.
Yeah.
I hope Colbert sticks to his strategy. I love it. I think he's doing something completely different, something new. He's bringing on these really brilliant people to speak about issues that really matter in the world. But I think if there's one thing that they have to do, it's sort of up their game. Maybe go out and get a stage trainer, talk to someone who's been on the show. They have a big network and Rolodex that they can reach out to.
Yeah. Well, so what do you think? Do you agree with Austin? Do you think that you want to continue seeing Colbert raise the level of intelligence at late night, or is his smart talk just putting you to sleep? Let us know, hashtag 29th floor on Twitter. See you next week. Thanks.